So this week we're going to start a new pillar, and it's pillar number 4. And it's simply called developing the muscles of cultural discernment. So you might think that's a funny title, but if you think about this in terms of developing your own muscles in your body, if you go to the gym, as you can tell, I probably haven't gone in a very long time, but if you develop the muscles in your body, you actually have to work at them. And they don't just come overnight. You don't wake up one day and you've got all this muscles and you're all developed and well-ripped. You actually have to work at it. And so the same thing goes with understanding the times in which we live. We need to develop them and work at it and to understand where we are. Now, why is this important? This is important because this world often is asking for us to have an account for why we believe in Jesus as our Savior. Well, without an understanding about the culture in which we live, oftentimes we can get swept away in the prevailing culture in which you are in. There's an old saying that says, fish don't know they're thirsty. What does that mean? Well, basically, because they're always in the water, they don't know whether that they are actually in water. It's just the environment in which they swim, in which they live, and they breathe water. So they don't know to be thirsty. And the same thing goes with us in our culture. We're immersed in the culture that we're in. Do we actually know or have an understanding of how much that culture is affecting us every day of our lives? More and more as we rely on screens and social media and the internet to give us a sense of what's right and what's wrong, we can sort of get swept away in the culture of our day. For today, I want you to think this through, that as you look around at the culture, are you actually aware how much that culture affects the way you think and the way you live and even the way you feel? Until next time, I'll see you tomorrow.